Good afternoon. It's Dean Calhoun with Affygility Solutions here to present Whiteboard Friday. And today we have a question from one of our listeners. And the question is, what determines the category 1 through 4? Is it the biological activity or the OEL or occupational exposure limit? Well, that's a very interesting question, but I want to make sure we understand things clearly. The OEL, which is the point of departure times the body weight of the individual, and that can be anywhere from 50 to 70 kilograms, depends on how conservative you want to be, and then that's divided by a composite uncertainty factor, and that's a whole nother show. We'll talk about that. Times steady state times absorption divided by 10 cubic meters, which is the number of cubic meters of air that you would breathe in an 8-hour work shift. So it's important to understand that OELs are based on an 8-hour work shift. Well, the OEL is based solely on the toxicology of the compound. It has nothing to do with engineering controls. So you take that OEL, and then you take other factors, such as the severity of the effect, such as any skin absorption issues, skin irritation issues, and then you combine those all together, and you come up with an occupational health categorization. Now, that categorization could be 1 through 4. It could be 1 through 5. It could be 1 through 6. It depends on the individual company's system that they're using. And that the number of categories really depends on the professional judgment that company and the system that the company wants to employ. Now, so that's the occupational health category. Now let's talk about control bands. Now control bands are a function of engineering controls that you will use, administrative controls such as medical surveillance or procedures that you might use, and the personal protective equipment. Now we have many, many different control banding systems out there. So you can have a traditional 4-band system. You can have a 4-band system where they split the third band, the 3-band, into a 3A or 3+, and then you can have 5-band systems. It really depends on the company and the amount of engineering controls that they have at their facility. In reality, many companies only have 2-band systems, but they may divide things up into further categories. For example, if you have a laboratory hood that you handle the non-potent compounds, that would be considered one part of your control band. If you have an isolator, that would be considered another part of your control band. So back to our original question, what determines the category 1 through 4, the biological activity or the occupational exposure limit? Well, to get to that, the occupational hazard category is primarily determined by the OEL, which is determined by the point of departure, which could be the lowest daily therapeutic dose. It could be a single acute study. It really depends on what stage of drug development you are. The OEL should be determined by a professional toxicologist. And here at Affygility, we'd be glad to help you out in that area. But there's other factors that may not be considered in the OEL that you might have to consider to actually determine the occupational hazard category. Once you have the OEL, then you would take the OEL and fit it in the appropriate control banding band based on the OEL and the capabilities of the band and the capabilities to control that. So I hope that answers your question. Look forward to many other questions. If you have other questions, please tweet me at Affygility. And you can also put the #potent safety, and we'll be happy to answer those questions. Thank you. You keep asking the questions, and we'll keep answering them. Thanks a lot, and have a great day.